Night of the Living Geek.
Welcome to the Last Dauntless Gamers with your hosts, Nick, Taylor, Connor, and Jake.
Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to this episode of Last Dauntless Gamers.
What's up, hot guy?
I know. Yeah, it sure is a hot guy right now.
I know.
Yeah,
we're in this smoking really hot garage.
We got the thing open. It's, you know, there's a nice little breeze, at least on this side of the table. I don't know.
It's just this is not really a hot day. Just wait until it's like burning outside and we're just gonna be like toasting.
Yep.
It's gonna suck.
Get some s'mores going.
It's a new thing today.
God damn it.
We're doing a live recording. Hi, people.
What up?
How's it going?
It's not really live, but yeah, hey, guys.
Yeah, you know what I meant. Video recording, okay, guys?
Posted later.
Yeah. There we go.
Atta babe.
So we're testing this today. we don't have all our cool gadgets and game stuff yet.
You guys getting this fridge right now?
Yeah, look at the fridge. There's Star Trek up there if you...
Yep.
That's some nerd stuff.
Hey.
Hey.
Moving on.
So this week is going to be our E3 week. Are you guys excited for E3?
I took off 3 days, so yes, I'm absolutely excited.
I took off 5 days.
Damn.
I faked my death at my work, so yeah.
Well, Connor wins.
No, it's going to be fun. I'm looking forward to just kind of chilling here all day, playing games, talking about games, watching games, and
yeah, because we are having a live stream.
Yeah.
Yes.
We're having a live stream that all you can go and watch at twitch.tv/dimlos2003.
I look forward to the end of E3. My brain will just be like a hot bowl of like steaming, like melted jello. Like that's going to be me by the end of E3.
Because you guys have never like watched, like sat and watched it all day.
I've done it once. I think it was 2012. I think I did. But even then, not all 3 days. Yeah. I only did it for one day.
This has been like a tradition for Taylor and I for the past like 3 years, 4 years.
Right.
Yeah, it's so much fun because you just sit like you're a total slug eating food all day, watching great game stuff.
Sounds like you're stoked about that.
Oh, yeah. I'm great. I'm so excited. You have no idea.
I think some L&L is going to be in order.
Oh, absolutely.
But then you'll be dead afterwards.
We just need to obliterate ourselves.
Yeah.
But yeah, at least this time, it's not going to be like 90 degrees in our house.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, we did our old apartment last year, and it was so hot. We had to like sit there with ice packs on our chest and stuff. Like it was bad.
It was awful.
So good, dude. Love picture.
Now
that.
We have air conditioning and a nice, comfy couch, and it's gonna be good.
But yeah, I look forward to being indoctrinated into the E3 cult.
Hopefully, it's a good year because I felt like last year was a little weak. There were a lot of conferences where like EA had a show where half of it was just like, here's like models with no textures and like we don't even know what this is, but like here it is, like it's a thing that we're working on,
check it out.
Yeah,
it wasn't like three of their announcements canceled during that thing where they showed up. I was like, yeah, we're making this new IP, and it got canceled. And then they're like, oh, we're making this cool new MOBA, and that got canceled.
Like, oh, wow. Yeah, BioWare was making a MOBA, they canceled that.
Really? Would it be set in one of their existing universes?
No, it was some original thing, or it was like they're trying to resurrect an old one. I forgot, I can't remember what it was called.
It looked like when I saw it, I'm like, this looks exactly like League, like cartoonish, like that, mm-hmm. and everything.
Oh,
nah. Yeah, it's probably just trying to, you know, bite off that same style.
Well, see, I would guess not, because BioWare, I don't know, they've got a nice little reputation. They're true. Usually a little, you know, honorable. They've got good stuff, good morals.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd hope not, but it does sound like it. Yeah. I
would love you got a point there.
I would love to see a Templar versus like, you know, Commander Shepard or something like that.
A Templar
from Assassin's Creed.
Oh.
Not Assassin's Creed.
What is Templar?
Isn't it
from Dragon Age? Dragon Age. Sorry.
A Templar versus Shepard. Why would you want to see that? You would just
universe.
See Shepard killing a person. Like the Templar
exactly.
wouldn't stand a chance.
Yeah,
it would be
seen
nothing.
That before.
No, but maybe like a mage. You know, that'd be cool. Like some of the mages from Dragon Age versus, you know, one of the engineers or something from Mass Effect.
How about one of the mages from Halo 5 with space magic?
God.
Space
there's
magic,
not going to be
dude.
Space magic in Halo 5.
#space magic.
No, there's no space magic in Halo.
Magic.
God damn it.
That's going to be a thing now, every time. Halo 5 space magic.
No space magic in Destiny either, right, Jake?
No, there's kind of space magic in Destiny. Yeah. Okay, like, okay. That's even too much of a stretch. It's like technically, you know, Bungie might go like, no, it's technology. AI, it's a little space magic.
We broke Jake on that one. I remember specifically in the past, you're like, no space magic. And now he's like, okay.
Yeah, Warlock shooting energy bombs, that's kind of
in
space
Destiny,
magic.
But it's not in Halo 5.
No, it's Halo 5 Guardians, choose your destiny.
Oh my God!
Is that really what it's called?
No, it's not.
Is that the tagline?
No, it's not the tagline.
Wouldn't that be funny if that was the tagline?
You know, Guardians were in Halo before they were ever a part of Destiny. So
here I heard a funny thing today. Apparently, what Bungie is trying, or not Bungie 343, I guess, is trying to do is like wean themselves off numbers. So they're like, it's gonna be Halo 4, Halo 5, Guardians, and then like Halo 6 is not gonna be called Halo 6.
Yeah,
it's gonna be like
Halo
something.
Gonna be
kind of like what Assassin's Creed's doing.
Kinda doubt it, to be honest, because they. The contract is for a second trilogy, so 3,
right.
So 4, 5, and 6.
It will be 6, but it's just not going to be called.
But what,
6.
What I mean is that, like, if that's the last one, if they haven't renewed the contract, which so far they haven't, or at least as far as the public knowledge, right?
Mm-hmm.
But if there's not going to be a 7, 8, or 9, why in the hell would they change number 6 and that's it?
Someone messed up.
Well, I don't know. Why would they subtitle it Guardians? They've never done that before. It's like
I know,
in the middle of the
and
trilogy.
That is also super weird. So I don't know. I don't know what they're going to do.
They're probably like, oh, we're making another trilogy. And then they're like, okay, never mind. We're not going to make another trilogy. We're just going to make stories. Because isn't this Halo 5 story just completely out of nowhere?
No. Not at
all. Spartan Locke, he's like a voice.
Nick,
like,
are you talking about things you don't know, Nick?
I'm asking questions because we have
the
Halo God here.
He's like, hey, Jake, isn't it totally like this one way? And Jake's like, no, it's totally other way.
No, the story's not out of nowhere at all, especially where we last left Master Chief. It's like this is a very feasible way for the story to have gone.
Just like space magic.
What?
See, now
you're
just
stretching it. Just go to the freaking topic, Nick. I'm tired of talking about this crap with you.
But this has been a very interesting week. Lots of game announcements.
Lots
Holy
and lots
crap.
Of game announcements.
Like all the game announcements.
Yeah.
They're all trying to squeeze in their wad before E3 pops off and everything gets real crazy.
Yes, yeah. But the weirdest thing is that Bethesda kind of, like, you know, came early. Fallout with premature, you know.
That was fantastic, though. I liked, you know, it was a lot of fun seeing that countdown. It was all like this nice graphic, and it was all Fallout-y. Like, I thought that was really cool.
Was it you who hit me up and told me about that? And I was like, fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
And, it was during our drive.
Yeah. And so they announced it at, what, 7 in the morning or something like that?
Yeah.
So, you know, I woke up early and watched the countdown hit 0, and the trailer didn't pop up. Immediately. Which
yeah,
was actually,
the stream
was
behind,
it was really
but then
frustrating.
It went up on YouTube immediately.
Yeah,
it was so weird.
Yeah, so I found it, like, I was waiting, watching this thing for, like, 5 minutes, you know, occasionally, like, looking around, going, like, hey, is anyone else not able to find this? And then I found, you know, people were starting to link just to the YouTube, and I'm just like, what? So I clicked on the YouTube link, and it was the trailer. And I went back to the please stand by thing, and it was still saying please stand by, and I'm like, what?
That sucks.
For what?
It hits 0, and for, like, 15 seconds, you're just staring at the zeros, like,
yeah.
All right.
Like, here it comes.
Let's go,
I'm
dude.
Standing by and being patient.
Yeah.
That's like the roller coaster taking you all the way to the top, and then you just stop
just,
at the top for a
dies.
While, and you're kind of just like looking around.
Like, oh, like, man, this is going to be crazy. They're building it up. Oh, man.
Start to get a little anxious.
Oh, man.
And all of a sudden,
yeah, right, go.
Then suddenly he goes, here comes a new challenger. Like, Smash Bros. Like, what?
Yeah, right.
What?
Exactly.
Dog meat joins the fray.
Classic.
Shit.
NCR Ranger joins the fray.
So you guys have actually played the old Fallout game, so I'm curious to know what you think, because everybody was like hyped. That trailer has like 8 million views now, and I don't know anything about Fallout, so I just watched that trailer, and I'm like, okay, that the graphics don't look really that great, and I don't really, nothing about that is like really going, holy shit, I can't believe it. So I mean, like, so somebody that's played them, did that trailer speak to you in like an interesting way at all?
I think most of my excitement comes from just the quality that I've come to associate with everything they do. Not even like the trailer, but the trailer is sweet. So, I mean, that got me pumped. But I knew Fallout 4 was going to be great anyway. So it was kind of just more confirmation of what I already knew to be true.
Okay.
You know, I actually watched this video earlier today, and it was, I want to say 8 minutes, something like that. But it was by this group. And of course, I can't remember the name of them either, but I'll actually link it to our Facebook page so you guys can check it out.
Shout outs.
But yeah, no, because they did a fantastic job. So what they did is they took all of the different shots from different, you know, from the trailer, and they found landmarks that were very similar. Like, there was one landmark in particular. There was this big radio tower that they found.
Oh.
And they actually, like, looked at that in the distance and, like, compared shadows and, like, time of day and all this so that they could figure out what direction each shot was facing, how far away things were. So they found out that Boston, which is where the next one takes place, it's scaled down to approximately one third of Boston's size, which is going to
So they
pretty much have an approximation of like what the Fallout 4 map is going to be, which is just awesome how they did that.
Nice.
But I guess it means it's going to be about two times the size of Skyrim, which kind of fits into. Yeah. I mean, that's realistic. That's like the scope.
An actual city.
Yeah, and that's the scope, you know, that that we've come to know them. So like it's. It's really cool, and it was awesome. They even showed like where the nuke dropped approximately. It's in this little town in Boston called Brighton, which they thought, you know, Bethesda would do because it also kind of has that kind of radiation-y kind of name. You know, Brighton is where the bomb fell. You know, like it's
everything's
just,
glowing.
And they found out where the vault is, where everything else is. That big weird tower that they used as a landmark was MIT. It's just like it's really. It was so impressive watching that video. So I'll definitely link that. But it's. It got me even more excited, like more than the actual trailer itself, to be honest.
Yeah, I'm going to have to check that out, dude, because like two times the size of Skyrim, anyone who's played Skyrim knows that you could waste a lot of time running around that map. So that's just awesome to hear, especially because, I mean, without even seeing a trailer, I could tell you that like this, just the depth of you know, like the playability of the game is going to be so much deeper and like better that just like exploring that giant wilderness will definitely be a worthy adventure.
And I keep wondering if that dog is going to be a constant companion or not. You know, because like...
Is it dog meat?
No, it doesn't look like dog
confirmed?
Meat.
Confirmed?
But like, it is kind of interesting. A lot of people have been saying like, you know, it could be almost fable-y where you have a dog always with you. And that's just, that's almost like part of your character.
That'd be kind of cool.
Having
like scavenger Torchlight. Stuff or whatever.
Yeah. Torchlight, shout out.
Oh, yeah. Oh, great. Dude, yeah. Torchlight. Hell yeah.
So, I went with the cat though, but same shit.
I got this weird, I don't even know how I got it, but I got this weird rare item that permanently transforms your dog into an ogre. So I had an ogre follow me around the entire game.
That's pretty awesome.
I don't know how I got it, but it was just in my inventory since I started. So whatever.
Oh,
but it was awesome because the knockback.
Right.
Almost everything would just die instantly.
Torchlight shout out.
Yeah. Torchlight's a great game.
So I know we got a lot of cover and I don't want to go like dwell on Fallout 4 too much.
Yeah,
but what did you guys think about the graphics? Because that was like the one thing of contention. A lot of people thought it didn't look good. Especially in comparison to like recent games like Witcher, a lot of people thought Witcher looked better and Dying Light and stuff. Like the graphics, a lot of people were saying were a little underwhelming.
I you go first this time.
No, I think that it's true. Dying Light and The Witcher definitely look better. Yeah, honestly, I might argue even Skyrim is kind of. Comparative to Fallout 4, but at the same time,
not
I don't care too much. Skyrim still looked great. If Fallout 4, if the entirety of Fallout 4 looks like Skyrim, but has the scope of what we're thinking, maybe Fallout 4 has. I mean, I'd be totally happy with that. Honestly, even I mean, Skyrim was a great looking game. Fallout 4, I wouldn't be too disappointed.
Okay.
It would be cool if it looked better. But
Skyrim had good looking characters.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they
Fallout
did.
4,
huge improvement over Oblivion,
but didn't have good looking. Terrain,
yeah. Skyrim.
No, there is a bunch of places where it just looked like really bad.
I don't know. I thought there was places where it looked freaking awesome.
Yeah,
yeah.
So
a lot of the wilderness.
I think Fallout 4 has like kind. It doesn't look the character models don't look as good, but the environment looks amazing. Like they showed off the environment a lot, and it looked really good.
Yeah, that
character
like
models
in the highway. Yeah, it looked really interesting.
The character models just didn't look like. Looks like they need some work on it.
And there's still time. Here's the thing, though. I appreciate that it was in-game. It wasn't some CG trailer. It wasn't a bullshot, as we've come to call them. and it wasn't disingenuous. Like, this is what the game's going to look like. Maybe it's not super impressive, but at least we're being honest with you. So I can appreciate that.
And, I mean, it's not going to go the way of Watch Dogs. You know, people aren't going to be complaining about graphical, lowering.
They're not going to Ubisoft it up.
Yeah. So we know we're getting ourselves into
verb.
They're you know, getting
so
us
bad
good
for
expectations.
Ubisoft.
So. Anyway, yeah.
Real quick, for me, as far as the graphics, it's like, I know with the scope of that game, it's going to be like the last thing I care about. And like, kind of like Jake said, if it looks anything like Skyrim, like, I'm not going to be mad. And plus, like, I don't have as much like latest gen experience as some of you, as you guys know, because I don't have a PS4, so it doesn't hit me quite as hard just because I don't know what I'm missing, I guess. But other than that, like, the scope of the game is what I'm like more concerned about.
I just like, if I can point out that you said I don't have too much of an next-gen experience because I don't have a PS4.
Yeah,
like,
I guess
you didn't say anything about the Xbox One.
Yeah,
exactly.
I was like,
it's like, you
it
could totally have an Xbox One. It's like, I just don't have the great next gen experience on PS4.
Well, that's where it's
I guess that's where we stand.
Yeah, well, because that's what we all have. So
it's, yeah, right. We all own. We have nothing against the Xbox One. Shut up.
I just have a PC, so I don't know a goddamn thing.
My PC's a good one.
Mm-hmm. And the Vita that Nick got me, shout out.
What up?
Anyways.
Fine. Just let me hang.
Oh,
you
were actually going
That'd
for the
weird.
Skin, dude.
Yeah.
Give me skin.
There you go.
I was giving you the finger of truth.
Yeah.
Which is just as good.
How do you feel, Taylor? You've just been Eiffel Towered.
Oh, whatever. I'm all right with it.
Well played, Jake.
All right.
All right. The next one, XCOM 2. Jake, you are a big XCOM fan.
Mm. I am. I enjoy XCOM, but I don't have a PC. And this is PC only, and that makes me so sad.
There's so much just like pained resignation in your voice and face right now.
God. And I get, you know, I guess the developer really, they know PC, they don't know consoles very well, so it was a huge pain in the ass for them to make the first one. But it's just, man, it's so disappointing. I had so much fun with that on 360, Enemy Unknown and Enemy Within.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that was great.
They might do a late port, because that's what they did last time, I want to say.
It was pretty, like quick, though. It was like, here's the PC release, and now here's the console release. Okay. So we don't know. They might be doing the same thing. You never know.
Maybe.
Take more time with it, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
They are smaller. Those are the guys that make Civilization, same guys. So
seriously?
Yeah, Firaxis, yeah, same guys. So, like, their budgets aren't massive. So, like, maybe they're like, okay, we'll see how the PC does, and if it does really well, then we'll consider a console port.
Well,
so.
You know, that's actually something I wanted to bring up. It's just another game that I don't need to go into detail on, but it's just called Massive Chalice. It actually just came out for Xbox One. I don't know if it's already out for PC or not.
I think so, yeah.
Okay. So it's actually the game with gold this month, which is kind of cool. So if you have a gold subscription, you get Massive Chalice for free.
Shazam.
And I do. So I did, and I played it, and it's a ton of fun. It's pretty much... it's like... So take XCOM and then mix it with like Game of Thrones. Because you have houses and like you have generations. So it's what's cool about it is that when you advance time in XCOM, it goes, by like a day at a time, right? You know, it's like that's a few seconds, you'll get a few days in.
Mm-hmm.
In this, a few seconds, you get a few years in. So your heroes are constantly aging really quickly and dying. And then so you have to make sure they have a house, like a keep, so that they can have kids. And so you get these like large houses, these huge lineages. Full of powerful heroes.
Badass.
It's really awesome.
Huh,
yeah.
Cool.
So it's, and then it's kind of like The Sims in that respect too. Cause you almost, you know, it's like there's the drama of like, oh, they died. Who's going to take their place? Who will be queen regent?
Huh.
Who, or, you know, all this stuff.
Or your mighty hero has like a weak son and you just hate him or something.
Exactly. And that's kind of, that's an actual thing, you know, that, so it's, there's things like that where, you know, genetics actually comes into it where you want to breed the powerful heroes, but that also means, that also means that they can't fight anymore once you set them up with a keep. So you're trading, you know, your actual combat ability, you know, for
an
future. It's an investment.
Yeah.
And then there's also like I had this problem with inbreeding because
Jake,
what
have you done?
I had two houses, the Ashen Trees and the Sun Splitters. And they were both getting so huge that I pretty much only had Ashen Trees and Sun Splitters. So it's like, OK, this Ashen Tree is going to take over the new keep. Who's going to mate with them? A Sun Splitter, I guess. And then it just that happened a few generations, and I'm like, oh shit, like this is
you're playing God, Jake.
Yeah, I know. So I was like more houses, more keeps, I need more people. It's a lot of fun though. So if you like XCOM, you have an Xbox One, definitely check out Massive Chalice. Lots of fun.
We don't hate Xbox One.
If you have to say that, then there's already suspicion.
Okay.
No,
I don't hate Xbox One.
Moving
Nick.
On.
Anyway, so
that's you excited for XCOM 2?
No.
No?
Because I can't play it.
Right. I would love...
And
I would,
why would I be excited?
I would be excited for it, but like I can't fucking play it.
All right, so you could magically play it. Will you be excited for it?
Yes.
Good. There you go. Okay. That's all I wanted to know.
Okay.
Jeez.
Jeez, goddamn.
Connor, are you any interest at all?
It's like
a strategy. It's like a Western strategy RPG.
Permadeath.
I'm going to take a mulligan on this one. Yeah.
Yeah, I played the first one on PC. It's interesting.
The first one
or the XCOM?
Enemy Unknown?
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the recent. Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. It's a cool game.
Cool.
Hard, cool, but yeah, it's a cool game.
It is right. Super hard, yeah.
It's one of the, you know, whatever. Uncharted. One of those, whatever.
One of those.
Dude, I totally get you. Yeah.
I
had a brain fart, okay?
Uncharted's going to be fun.
Uncharted.
I haven't played it before.
I know. So people were getting mad on the game forums, like we discussed on last week's episode.
Nick is clearly salty about the saltiness.
Yes. About how Uncharted, it's a remaster. It's like, oh, great, another remaster. And then Jake just, like, you know, made a good point. He's like, he has never played it. A lot of people from Xbox 360 moved to PS4, never played any of the PS3 exclusive games.
And also just with the actual pattern of that specifically, 360 to PS4. Because yeah. 360 did win out last generation.
Yeah,
that was
PS3. Default, like, third-party kind of console.
Yeah, I mean, right. So the Xbox 360 definitely beat out the PS3. I mean, but PS2 won out over
original Xbox.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But barely over original Xbox, because Halo really sold that.
Exactly.
But at any rate.
That was a launch game.
PS2, uh-huh. And then 360, and then it's very clearly moving over to PS4 this generation. Yeah, so I think a lot of gamers are going to follow that. Gamers have already followed
that.
That's
exactly what this is for, though. It's for those people.
Yeah.
And if you want, and you know, us, if we want to buy it again. I want to, actually. It's kind of weird. I want to play them again, because I haven't played them for like 4 years, 5 years.
The one I want to play the most, because they said they're going to like add new textures and new lighting and stuff to make it look better. I want to see what Uncharted 1 looks like, because that game looks really bad in comparison to 2 and 3. Mm. Like, they even said, some of the developers, like, yeah, we don't have like skin shaders, so the characters look all rubbery and weird and way too shiny. Like, if you like put them next to each other, like, whoa, what the? Something's wrong, and I can't really put my finger on it.
Huh. Uncharted 1, was when it was first shown, looked amazing, which is funny.
Interesting.
Hmm.
Well, okay. Whatever HD remastering process they've been doing on the HD remastered games that have been coming out works, because that MGS3 remastered I've been playing, it's like, looks just
so yeah, Metal Gear Solid,
amazing.
Final Fantasy X and X-2, Master Chief Collection, which Sly can Koopa. I also say, yeah, Sly Koopa,
Kingdom
yeah.
Hearts.
Can I
really
also
great.
Just say, though, the Nathan Drake Collection.
Yeah,
they had to
off.
Make that the name of it,
yeah.
Not the Master Chief Collection. Come on. Like,
Is it going to be... So, yeah, your point. Or is it going to be
they're encroaching
another
on your
Uncharted with someone else?
What?
Like, they make is another it? Trilogy with a different
oh,
character.
Oh,
like they're
I
saying
see.
There
well,
will be the Nathan Drake
you okay,
know,
trilogy.
Okay,
but even then, you could have named
trilogy.
It... They could have named it, you know, the Nathan Drake trilogy, then. Or the, anything else. It's just weird that it's the exact wording, the, and the name of the protagonist.
Yeah,
the
Super Mario's the Super Mario Collection.
Yeah.
The same thing is... that's
the
like,
Mario Collection.
That's like the most basic format you could ever have for it. So it's like, you could see how it would be duplicated.
Yeah, I suppose.
At least
I
this
just thought
one
it was
will
kind
be
of
working
funny.
When
all.
It was launched.
You also, are, of course, a Halo apologist. So this is part of the
shut up, man.
One thing that's interesting about
not that there's anything wrong with that shit. I mean,
one
I
thing
Final that, Fantasy.
Exactly. Yeah, I'm with you there, Connor. One thing that's interesting: no multiplayer. There will not be the multiplayer from 2 and 3.
I don't think that's.
I just read somewhere where they're gonna have a beta test
of 4. Yeah.
Oh, a 4.
Yeah, yeah.
October 17th.
I don't know if it's gonna be there day one, but eventually, it's like we're still waiting for that Doom beta, right? So.
Oh, yeah.
So I don't know if it'll be there day one, but
no, I know. I mean,
right.
Well,
how long after was Master Chief Collection? Did you get the Halo 5 beta?
A month or two, I believe.
Okay,
wasn't it?
Sure.
No.
It was pretty long. I think wasn't it released like in summer, and then Christmas time was when the
Master
beta
Chief Collection
was
came out in summer, I think. Or no, it went to. Like,
I,
the
I can't remember.
No,
I'm
columns.
Pretty sure it was like no. I'm pretty sure it was like January that I was playing the beta.
Okay.
It was around New Year's, and I can't remember when Master Chief Collection came out, but it was around the beginning of this year, in January, I think, that I was playing the beta.
So okay. When the beta for the Master Chief Collection came out, did they call it the Master Beta?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, dude.
That's funny.
I've said it before.
Like,
I've said it before. I'll say it again. I'm a piece of shit.
No, that's funny. But no, as far as Uncharted not having multiplayer, I mean, what? That's way too ambitious. To bring back all of the old games remastered and with multiplayer, I mean, that's what? 3 games? How can they do that and multiplayer? That's incredible.
Well, I think they probably saw the Master Chief Collection and were like, fuck that. I don't even want to deal with that. People won't play Uncharted for the multiplayer anyway, so...
That's true. It did take about 5 weeks or so for Master Chief Collection to actually get its shit together and start
and
working.
They're still
patching it though, aren't they?
They're patching it, but
if
it works.
If you
works
play
almost
with groups, okay. It still crashes.
Why? I haven't seen that at all.
Because you've never played with the groups, because you're the only one who has an Xbox One.
Yeah. All right, fine.
But either way, I'm excited. Should be fun.
I'm kind of sad there's no multiplayer, because the multiplayer was pretty fun. I want to play the multiplayer with Jake.
Well, I think that Uncharted 4 is just going to kind of make the old ones obsolete, to be honest.
You are true. You what? Are true.
You are true.
What?
Yeah. You are right.
You are saying the truth.
Thank you.
You
good.
Are saying
the truth. Jake, soothsayer.
Yeah, Nick, the grammatical virtuoso.
You
of
are
our
true.
You are true.
You are not to lie.
All right. What's next thing? What's the next thing you got?
This is one's for this guy right here, Taylor. Stella was removed from Final Fantasy 15.
Yeah, this is
officially.
Yeah, they had Square Enix does this thing called the Active Time Report, hosted by the director of Final Fantasy 15. He just gives it regular updates, and they're patching the demo for Episode Duskai, which comes
is that
out
how
next
you pronounce
week.
It? Duskai, I thought it was yeah. Duskai.
Duskai. Yeah, they said it a couple times. Duskai. But anyway,
tell the people what is that.
So it's when you bought Final Fantasy Type Zero HD, you got a demo for Final Fantasy 15, and dubbed it Episode Duskai. And they're making up 2.0. They're like, patching a demo, which is weird, but
is
they're like
weird.
Making they're improving the frame rate at different enemies, different animations and stuff.
That's actually cool. Kind of cool.
Yeah,
yeah,
it's interesting.
It's because it's such a big demo, yeah,
for sure. So anyway, yeah. Then they were talking about like stuff they were talking about with 15, like as they're progressing along with development. There was this. The main like heroine or love interest was this character named Stella. She was in trailers for a long time, and then they introduced this character Luna in one of the latest trailers. And people were like, "Okay, is that the same character? Because they share the same last name." It was kind of confusing.
Don't they look alike as well?
They look a lot alike. Yeah, they're almost identical.
Stella just became Luna,
pretty much. Yeah,
Stella.
So when they're talking about cutting that character. I mean, it just really sounds like it's instead of just they just changed their name.
Yeah, that's
edited.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, we don't even know
Stella,
what that character.
Luna.
Yeah.
It's close enough anyway. I mean, I don't know.
I don't really understand it. I mean, I don't really know what the story was anyway. So who?
So
knows?
There's no reason to really give a shit then.
Yeah, but people were losing their minds. Like, oh, we knew so much about this character, and I can't believe they were taking it around. I'm like, dude,
they're probably just so far up their own asses. I mean, if you said that, I'm sorry. But
was
whatever.
There a lot of information about her though?
I mean, kind of. There was trailers, and there were interview bits and pieces that talked about like who she was and her relation to their characters, but not like a deep lore. Like,
so it's kind of like
I mean I made that giant video and I don't really know much about her. So okay. if anybody should know something about her, it's me, and I don't really care.
It's like if a month before right. Splatoon came out, they replaced all the Inklings with Mario characters.
Yeah, that'd be bad.
People are just like, what? People, but our cosplay.
People just like committing mass suicides. And just my Inklings.
Well, cool. That sounds good.
Yeah. So, I mean, update for the game. And they also said there's not going to be any trailer at E3, which is kind of a bummer. I mean, this is two E3s in a row that they're skipping it. But they said at Gamescom there's going to be some major updates, which leads me to believe.
That's right next to
it. Yeah, it's only 6 weeks after because they've. E3 got pushed back and Gamescom got pushed forward, so
maybe they're trying to avoid that, you know, on purpose.
Yeah, for
Could
sure.
Could be just a strategic move, yeah.
Yeah, which is fine.
I've been thinking with the FF15 thing. I know it's a huge project, but like, is there a point where like there's too much like hype behind your game and it'll never live up to what people want?
That's what I said on Twitter. That's literally what I said. I'm like, this game is never gonna live up to the like what people created in their minds. But I'm just like, I hope it's fun. That's kind of all I'm hoping for at this point. And I even said I'm really tired of hearing about it.
Well,
like,
that's
want the
where
game
the
to come out.
That's where the non-hype strategy comes in handy, because you're like, whatever, I'll just wait and then
just
you know.
Maximum aloofness. Just kind of just hang out in the corner like whatever. Yeah,
my specialty.
Cool.
And Nick, he's like, yeah, whatever. Oh, and the game comes out. Okay, yeah, that's cool.
No. I'm saying that the developers should assume that role of just like, nah, whatever. Yeah, we got a game coming out, you know. Yeah, you've heard about it, I know, but
here's
nah, whatever. Yeah. Oh, you want okay, I guess we can give you like a trailer or something, whatever. Yeah,
oh, okay, whatever.
Yeah. I'm curious to see how just that the whole FF15 like from now until release saga unfolds.
I'm expecting sevens.
I feel like there's going to be some controversy somewhere down the road. I feel it in my
Sid's boobs
duodenum.
Are too big.
Oh yeah, I'm sure we're going to hear some feminist articles about that on Polygon.
Oh yeah, Sid's a chick in this one, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
And she's hot.
To clarify,
and she's
Sid,
hot.
Sid is her dad, and her name is Cindy. So it's
so she so goes.
It might
is
as well
her.
Be the same thing, but to clarify, that's.
But so it's not Sid then?
No.
So what
her
the
dad's
fuck?
Sid, yeah.
People.
So is Does he have a cigar though?
Like
a-
I don't know. They didn't show in the demo. They're like, okay, make sure to say hi to Sid for us. And well, like,
it's only Sid in FF7 that's always smoking. Most of the other Sids.
He's just a mechanic. That's like the general.
See, that's the only stipulation for being a Sid in a Final Fantasy game is you have to be an engineer, a mechanic, building airships or some shit.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
Like every single one.
I've learned something today.
Or you could just work at a shop in Kingdom Hearts.
Or, you know, be a frog man.
Yeah, exactly. Be a frog.
I play Tales games.
Yeah, I guess it's not always a ship builder, but that's a common theme because there's Headmaster Sid in FF8.
Yeah.
And then Regent. I'm flying off the rails here. No one gives a shit.
And the Judge Sid in Final Fantasy Tactics Advance. Sid's a judge.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. He's a badass in that game.
You're totally lost.
I mean, I get some of it.
God, you're such a piece of shit, Jake.
I'm enjoying Final Fantasy X. Yuna said something about Sid once in it.
Oh, man.
Well, there's a Sid in that game, and he's a mechanic, I think.
Oh, spoilers.
He's a pilot or whatever.
Wow, wait. Come on, Taylor.
I mean, that happens pretty early in the game.
Wow, you might as well tell me about the last 2 hours of the
game. I'm already like...
You might as well tell me there's a chocobo
15
in
hours.
Wow, let me guess. Gil is the currency? So mad at you, dude.
Wait, what the hell's Gil?
And there's bolt 2 spells?
Oh, man.
All right.
So, anyway, moving on.
Hashtag FF.
Yeah, I am enjoying that remaster, though. It's a ton of fun. Tidus is...
Pretty much.
Tidus is so annoying, though. Good God.
Yeah.
He's the worst... He's the worst protagonist I've ever played as.
Have to dredge up these horrible memories that are just like, I'm going to start just
I'm serious.
Convulsing.
And I just think it's hilarious. Like, the rest of the party even knows he's that guy of the group.
We gotta play this fucking
like, the only reason he's there is because Yuna, for some freaking reason, finds him funny. That's right. It. And everyone else is like, come on, Tidus. He's like the weakest fighter. He's just... shitty. He's
and like
just
Orin
terrible.
Is the true badass, right?
Oh, yeah.
And I love I wish that every time like Tidus said something, Orin just kind of goes like
he pretty much does. Everyone does. Like Kimari, everyone's just like, yeah, all right. It's really weird. All right, sorry.
Final Fantasy Tactics.
Fuck Tidus.
Sid is like the ultimate holy sword.
Oh yeah, he's just basically the game breaker.
Never use
like,
him.
Once you get Sid, you break the game.
Pretty much.
Yeah, that's why we developed not using Sid ever in her game.
Yeah, exactly. We would just not use him because then you'd have to just beat the game by actually being good at it instead of beating the game because you have Orlando.
Yeah, there is no difficulty. It's like Orlando or no Orlando. Those are the difficulty modes.
It was Orlando like Sid, right?
Yeah. Okay.
Thunder God Sid.
Yeah, Thunder God Sid is like his name, okay. So I guess.
I remember there was a Sid in there. All right.
Anyway.
Night Terrors, a new augment reality
Night Terrors.
For your phone.
Dude, I've been playing this game since I was a little kid. Now there's an app for it.
Apparently.
Yeah. I always thought they sucked really bad. I guess they're cool.
So, no, it's coming out January of 2016. And it's an augmented reality one. So you kind of hold your phone up, right? You hold it horizontally, I believe, and it has a little record symbol in the bottom left. And, you know, so you turn off all the lights in your house and you explore your own house. And it kind of has a PT vibe. So it has like little bits of like radio sound coming out of the audio. And also it's going to be headphones the entire time.
Wow.
And so you can only see because the flashlight on the phone is kind of lighting the way. But at times, you know, the flashlight will flicker. It'll like dim or it'll die entirely, you know, and then when it pops back up, there's like a monster. So, but you're trying to like look just at your phone the entire time. Right. And so it kind of acts kind of like that like PT or what was that other Outlast where it's like a lot of it is the digital kind of thing.
Except you're actually doing
it. Yeah, you're actually doing it. And so
that's
now
so fucking
the coolest
cool.
thing. So first thing, I had like two worries about it. The first one was the visuals. How cheesy and how shitty are they going to be? How is it going to be able to put? How is it going to be able to put all the monsters in the right spot? And apparently, that's the main thing they're working on is like figuring out, is getting that technology so that if you look down a hallway and there's a door at the end of it and it's open and there's complete blackness there, they'll be able to recognize that that's a door, recognize that it's pitch black beyond, and then put eyes there looking at you.
That seems like some pretty advanced shit, though, just like the recognition of things in real time.
But if you think about it, most of it's, you know, most houses are geometrical and all that. I mean, I think that, you know, you could, if you can have face recognition software, you can have door recognition software.
Yeah,
you know, totally. You can have hallway recognition software. But
you got me on that one.
So there's going to be that stuff. Also, the timing with all the lighting and all that stuff is going to be really cool in the audio. The second worry I had was the audio, was how is it gonna, you know, is it gonna sound out of your crappy little phone speaker, you know, you're just gonna, it's gonna be weird. So use headphones, and it's actually gonna use binaural audio, which, if any of you don't know what that is, are any of you familiar with iDoser?
Yeah, where it kind of like goes back and forth or whatever, right?
No.
No.
So that's
not
so that's,
not at all.
You might be talking about panning, where it just you know, it can tell like which speaker to come out of, right?
Mm-hmm.
But binaural audio. So iDoser is this application that was really big a few years ago, but it's audio drugs or audio. It's simulated feelings, and so they have a bunch of them. They have like a lot of them can be relaxing. A lot of them can be, you know, ways to pump you up or, you know, make you feel smarter, but. But anyway, it's actually about the audio waves can mess with your actual brain. So physically, it'll change what you're feeling. So when you listen to this stuff, it's not just like an emotion that you'll feel because the music is so good. It's like subliminal stuff. It'll literally like actually make your brain feel sad or scared. Yeah, exactly. So it does. So it's trippy. It's super trippy to actually listen to it. Because I've done it a few times, and it like really it's creepy. Like, it works very well sometimes. If it doesn't work,
I gotta say, my brain is fucked up enough as it is, so I don't need these guys tampering with my brain
but
chemistry.
It's really impressive how much it really can affect you. Possibly some people it doesn't work on very well. Others it works on immensely well. Were you gonna say placebo stuff or
no.
Okay? A lot of people, they kind of bring up placebo, and there've actually been a bunch of tests with that where it's.
But placebos can be effective. That's the
placebos
thing.
Can be, yeah. But like, they've done a lot of things where a lot of tests with this. You know, they say this is gonna make you feel depressed, and people listen to it, and it's actually making them happy. But they say it's gonna make you feel depressed, and then they feel happy. So it's like a lot the placebo
psychology.
Effect. Yeah, the placebo effect does actually come into it, does not come into it very much at all.
I just can't wait to
sounds
play.
Creepy.
Yeah, I just can't wait to use the app, turn around, and there's like the sheet ghost, like cute sheet ghost going boo.
With the eyes cut out.
Yeah, it's like,
And then you turn around again, and something's like eating your face. You're like, oh, God.
And it's on actually eating my face.
Yeah.
On the last level, the scariest part of the game, you turn the corner, and Nick Wind is there around the corner.
Holy shit, look at him. And I'm just like, the game you like sucks.
Yeah, exactly.
But, I feel like I'm never going to want to walk around in the dark after this.
Yeah.
Because you have to turn all the lights off for it to work.
Yeah. So anyway, sorry. I know I went on a tangent there. It's just...
It's an interesting one.
Using some really cool technology. It's got an awesome concept. The trailer, there's a trailer out for it where it's actually... you see, it's just zoomed in on some guy's phone, so you can see him holding it, and you can kind of see the room over the phone as well. But, you know, it's like, so you can kind of see what it's supposed to be like. But it just looks phenomenal. It looks,
awesome ideas.
Yeah, really cool. Sorry, I'm going to take a break from talking for a bit.
I didn't know anything about that, about Night Terrors. Now I'm super pumped, just because, like, conceptually, it seems like there's been a long time since there's a game that's like, holy crap, I haven't heard of anyone do that before. That, like, there's an actual... you called it augment reality. That's like the kind of name for that kind of concept.
Yeah, exactly. Augmented.
Where you use what you're actually seeing to make a game out of it. Mm-hmm. But that sounds like by far one of the best ways you could harness that technology.
Yeah.
Just to scare the living bejesus out of you.
The next thing they got to do is get the heartbeat monitors on the sides of your phone.
For Apple Watch or even with your Apple Watch.
Oh my God. Yeah, for the Apple Watch. Just so that it could monitor how freaked out you're getting. Like, so
you
cool.
get the high score.
Just use the Oculus Rift.
Well, that's what I was going to say, is I'm worried that the Oculus Rift might just completely overshadow this, but if
it's on a phone.
Yeah, the difference is you can walk around. In Oculus, you can't walk around. It has a cord connected to it, so you just have to sit there.
Oh, okay, interesting.
So they make a connection for the phone,
This is also just more accessible, too. Yeah.
Exactly.
I mean, just being honest, it's probably going to cost, $10 at most, on your phone, and then you're good to go. There's headphones.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. So, all right. Next
ready
one.
To piss myself.
There's a new Tales game that was just announced.
Yeah.
Tales of Berseria. We still haven't played Zestiria.
Haven't beat Tales of Destiny 2, so I'll get to that in like 75 years. But I'm excited. Woo!
Yeah, the new one. I have no idea. I haven't seen it. Taylor,
the only thing
it.
We know is the main character is a girl named Violet, and she's a pirate. And that's
she's
literally
Rudy.
All we know.
She's Rudy.
Yeah, it looks like Rudy.
Well, cowabunga, dude.
Consoles is the big announcement.
Oh, PS3 and PS4.
Finally.
Legit. Japan is so hooked on last gen, which it makes sense for Japan because that's the biggest audience, obviously. I wish they would just ditch it, though, man. Like, by the time that game comes out, PS4 will have been out, like, 3 years, probably.
Japan? Jesus.
Get with the times.
Yeah, man. And we're still waiting to see if...
Don't tell Japan what to do, Nick. Japan's his own man.
They're doing their own thing. And we're still waiting for Zestiria on PC and PS4. There's another day of Tales of Festival, so by the time this podcast comes out, that may have already been announced, but... As of right now, we don't know.
To be honest, I wouldn't care for Zestiria on PS4. I want the damn 3DS game.
What
Tales
3DS?
Of the World.
Oh, it's
Tales
like a,
of the World.
It's like a strategy RPG with all the Tales characters.
Holy shit.
Wait, I was like, how many Tales characters?
Have you seen that one?
Yeah, it's like, that sounds stupid. What did you say?
Like oh, a lot of the Tales characters from previous games?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, like, hell yeah.
It's all of them.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
It's like so, Dissidia, basically. It's like, yeah, oh, everything you think is cool is in a game.
Yeah, so it's like a strategy RPG, and then when you do fight, when you attack, the battle you do the battle system.
So it's like Fire Emblem style.
Is this?
I actually remember you telling me about this.
Is this the one that has mechs in it as well?
No, giant fighting robots, dude.
Mega Man's in it.
Yeah,
Mega Man. Super fighting robot.
Mega Man mechs.
Mega Man.
Okay. Tales games.
Yep.
Final Fantasy. It's
all
in there,
one.
Man. It's all
and,
in there.
And
Carter.
World of Warcraft.
And World of Warcraft. Yeah. It's all in there, buddy.
Boom. Oh, sick, dude. I'm so fucking pumped.
So, yeah. That's cool. I hope we do see the Tales of the World game for 3DS. I really want that.
And Mega Man Legends 3.
The Mega Man Legends 3. That's
R.I.P.
And get canceled again. But speaking of Mega Man, we forgot to add this. They are making a new Mega Man cartoon.
Seriously?
Yeah.
A new
you're
Mega
positive
Man
they're not going to cancel it?
On a
no,
like a television on like no a television guarantee. Network?
I guess they're making a new Mega Man cartoon.
Do you have any idea what channel? I mean, that's going to affect it a lot.
It says it's not coming out until 2017, so like okay. Who knows?
Because like, I mean, is it Spike TV? Is it AMC or
I
Disney
almost,
Channel?
I almost want to say it's going to be a Japanese anime, and then somebody like Cartoon Network will bring it over.
That'd be cool.
Or something.
If it was on Toonami or something like that.
Yeah,
that'd be great.
Any word on which Mega Man universe it's going to be, because there's several. There's the Mega Man Battle Network one, there's original Mega Man, and there's Mega Man X and Mega Man Legends.
There's
like
the remastering.
Don't forget Mega Man Soccer universe. Where everybody decides to play competitive sports with each other.
I'll still take you any day.
Oh, dude, Mega Man Soccer is the greatest.
I think it's just a reboot.
It's the worst.
It's just a reboot of the regular Mega Man, I think. And I think, I mean, come on, you got to think about this. They're making a new cartoon. Does that mean they're going to bring out another game?
One hopes. It should be out by like 2023, dude. It'll be sick.
20XX.
God damn it.
The year 20XX.
Well, if you go by Roman numerals, it means 2020, right?
Yeah, so, there you go.
All right. XSEED also announced like all the games they're bringing out. There's a lot of them.
I'll do a quick rundown. I don't want to talk about any of them in detail because I'll go on forever.
Rapid fire.
So they're doing the second Trails in the Sky that's coming out this year, hopefully.
Okay.
It'll be a PSP game, but it'll be playable on Vita and Vita TV. They're doing the next series in the Legend of Heroes saga or whatever.
Okay.
It's called Trails of Cold Steel, which is supposed to like refer to like weapons, like fighting with cold steel weapons or whatever. And so they call it a duology. It's not a trilogy. It's two games. So they're working on both of those simultaneously.
I've never heard that before.
Duology?
Yeah. I don't know how else you would refer to it, but that's what they called it.
Biology?
I don't know. Anyway, so those are coming
Fuck
out for
you.
Vita, for Vita and PS3.
Come on. Nothing?
Nothing over here?
Whatever. All right, fine.
The
just keep going.
Senator and Kagura game, Shit. Estival Versus, is coming out for PS4
and Vita.
And
number 2 as well.
And, yeah, I think it's called, Crimson something. I don't know what it's called. But Senator and Kagura, think of Dynasty Warriors, but it's a bunch of chicks with big boobs. That's literally what it is.
Wait,
so you pre-ordered it, Taylor?
Bikini what? Samurai Warriors 2? Because that was also announced.
Okay.
That is chaos.
So you've pre-ordered that, right?
Oh,
Taylor?
Yeah. No,
I think you already own it. You already own it.
Yeah,
you got it in Japanese.
Yeah. Well, I didn't think they were going to localize it because it's such a weird game.
I actually got the third-party mod where they're all naked.
Yeah. Shit. So that, and then there was one, there was this game, I never heard of it before. It's called Popo Croix or Polo Croix or something like that. And it's like a JRPG mixed with like Harvest Moon. It's called like Poyo Croix, a Story of Seasons fairy tale. I'm like, that is a mouthful of a title.
Wow.
Yeah.
I think you may have just like imagined that in like your wisdom tooth medication.
Wait, yeah. Is that just another Rune Factory?
I don't know.
Because
no, the graphics are way different. I looked up some gameplay. It looks way different.
No, but it's Rune Factory Fantasy Harvest Moon. And this one's called
blah, 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 Story of Seasons fairy tale. Yeah.
Oh, dude, Poon Factory? I saw that movie.
Poon Factory.
So is that the last one?
That's the last one I can think of. There was probably... That they have confirmed. So, yeah.
So,
and then they didn't say Ease 8, but that's coming eventually, and I'm sure they're going to localize that. That's for PS4 and Vita. But they didn't say anything about that.
So, Connor, that means you have lots of JRPG goodness coming your way.
Yeah, and those are like really old school classic games. They look old school, but they play like really interesting stories, really good characters. So they'll be playable in Vita.
For sure. Well, you better keep me on the forefront of what's coming out, dude.
I will definitely let you know.
And Jake?
Yes.
Do you need a Vita?
He already has a PS4 and Xbox One.
It's the only thing I got. I don't have time, man. I've got more stuff to play.
Like Wii U. What up, Splatoon?
Yeah. Yeah.
What say you?
Gotta stay fresh, right?
Gotta stay fresh.
See?
You can't get stale, man.
Okay.
I had to do it.
No, you didn't. No, you didn't.
I was like, I'm leaving right now. I'm just gonna get out of here.
You didn't have to.
All right. E3 time, man.
All right.
I'm super excited. It's three new conferences. This is very exciting times. They're all going to suck.
please refer to our last episode for clarification on how to deal with that type of gamer.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
That was the joke.
Sure.
He always says that.
Yeah. I like Jake's face.
Disapproving glance.
I'm not even mad. I'm just disappointed. All right.
Continue with your...
What
descent?
I'm looking forward to this E3. Actually,
are you?
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
Good.
But you said they're all gonna suck.
Yeah, because I was.
He was kidding. Oh, he was kidding. Come on.
I can't wait to see Bethesda stuff. Can't wait to see some EA stuff. I can't wait to see the flops of Ubisoft.
Ubisoft.
The latest batch of shittiness.
It's not gonna be shittiness. It's gonna look amazing, and then. 3 years from now, it's going to be shit when it comes
out.
We'll
see. What do they got on the burner that we know of?
Division.
Assassin's Creed. We're going to watch the Division. It's going to become
that's going to be awesome.
Third-person shooter.
If they don't change anything, if it all looks just like the original little tech demo thing did, then I'm still going to be stoked for it. And if I fall into the UB trap, then I do. But I'm still going for it day one, if it looks like the demo did.
If you come hobbling back to us after the Ubi trap claims one of your legs, do you?
Yeah. Come cry at us. If you get caught with the Ubi trap, we're going to film you, and you're going to be crying.
The Ubi trap is such a great moniker for that.
Watch Dogs.
It's perfect.
Watch Dogs wasn't that... It was the multiplayer was bad, but the single player, everything worked fine.
It was fine.
The games aren't broken, but they're just... There's some issues.
They're just diseased.
Like they're special. You know,
it was hyped too much, I should say.
I feel like the best Watch Dogs one they put was, out yeah. in the last couple of years was probably Far Cry 4. That didn't have, I don't think that had like crazy hype, and it just came out and was fun.
It wasn't on the caliber of Far Cry 3.
It was literally Far Cry 3 again. In snow. That's literally what it was. That's
like,
all it was.
When Far Cry 3 came out, it was awesome. It was new. It felt awesome. It felt like great.
Yeah.
They made Far Cry 4 just. Copy and paste.
It's like Skyrim with guns. So then they're like, oh, well, we'll just make Far Cry 4 in the snow. So it's like really like Skyrim with guns.
Oh, boy. So Ubisoft trap, maybe.
Ubi trapped.
Maybe. We're going to see Syndicate. Bees in the trap. We're going to see Syndicate in three other conferences. We're actually going to see Syndicate in the freaking EA conference somehow.
Wait.
I just know it's going to happen.
It'll be a crossover.
Oh, man. Oh, Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
Yeah.
Son of a...
You kind of did the baseball like, oh,
man. That was really frustrating. You got my hopes up right there. You're like, yeah, we're going to see Syndicate. And I'm like, Syndicate? Yeah.
Wait,
Syndicate,
that bad shooter that AA put out a
You
couple
shut
years
the
ago?
Fuck up, Taylor.
You too. One of you leaves. The other dies.
Shit, man. No, Syndicate was a fantastic game. Did you play it?
No.
Yeah, you didn't play it. Exactly.
It got bad reviews.
I could have answered
people...
that. Oh, it did. It
Dude,
got bad
didn't
reviews.
We do a whole bit.
It got bad
true.
Reviews.
Not
did
you
it
last week?
That's true. That's
oh,
true.
Man.
This is why we love Jake.
The shoe is on the other foot now, isn't
Son
it?
Son of a Taylor.
Gotcha.
Get me going.
So, okay. So, specifically, it sounds like you're excited for all the conferences, specifically what games.
Okay.
Let's change the subject, yeah.
Yeah. Who wants to dwell on shit?
So, Bethesda, Doom. Yes, Doom.
Maybe.
Doom.
I can't wait to see Doom.
They already confirmed they're going to show Doom.
I know.
They did?
Yeah.
Oh.
They showed like literally a 2-second teaser, and they're like, oh, see Doom
no,
at
that's
E3
right.
or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I remember that now.
Their intro music for that game should literally just be like crushing, brutal death metal.
It better.
Blast beats and...
Well,
like in the teaser, it was a pretty.
I think they
heavy
have to
vibe to it.
They have to make it different enough from Killing Floor 2, though. Honestly, like I think that's going to be a big comparison. It's just because Killing Floor 2 is going to be fresh on people's minds, fresh enough where it's going to be a lot of comparisons, at least aesthetically. You know,
I think Doom is such a big franchise that it's not going to matter.
Like, look at Rage
Fair
and
point.
Mad Max. Like,
yeah,
all
those
the comparisons
were like
between the two
game franchises. Like, Doom is has such a story lineage that I think people
ubiquitous.
Are going to way overlook Doom compared to Killing Floor. Like, as cool as Killing Floor is, that's like saying like, ooh, there's this new JRPG and it looks too much like Final Fantasy. Like, Final Fantasy will overshadow it,
right? Like, or some game
okay.
or some game comes out before FF15, people are like, oh wow, FF15 just looks like that game. Like, no, it's going to be the other way around. Motherfucker.
All right,
but why not both?
Why not? Yeah, exactly.
Porque no los dos.
Kind of interested in Fallout 4. I never really got into Fallout 3. I tried to on
because
my PC.
Because you're a bad person.
No, I tried to. I have it. I own it on my PC. It doesn't work on my Windows 7 PC for some reason.
Oh, weird.
And I have no idea. It just crashes like all the time.
Huh. Fucking PCs, huh?
I know. It's really annoying. I want to play that game.
Oh, man. It runs like a dream on my Windows 7, so sorry, dude.
I don't know what's up. Sony, I'm not really interested in anything Sony.
Really?
So Sony is just gonna surprise me.
What do they got?
Uncharted 4, and that's pretty much it.
Didn't they say?
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Well, I don't really care.
You don't care about Uncharted?
Like, I know what Uncharted is already.
Yeah.
Get it? I'm doing my thing. I want to see.
Well,
I want to see PlayStation.
Well, God,
back off, guys.
PlayStation All Stars 2.
Nick's nicking Taylor.
I want to play PlayStation All Stars 2.
Not gonna happen. That'd
be
but
cool.
Okay.
Well, why won't it happen?
Why would they make that game? Give me your answer.
Because it was
Super
fun.
Smash. I mean, it is. It's Super Smash competition. That's it.
Yeah, it was fun. If they do it right,
yeah.
Why does why make
a
game,
game
that's gonna be that's just gonna be a competitor to a game that's gonna be better? I mean, I don't know. Like,
well,
how do you
it's just because it's different markets. Yeah. You know, it's like this is the best that PlayStation owners can get.
Yeah,
and it,
didn't
it was
the first
fun.
One flop though? I guess that's what I'm getting at.
It didn't sell too well, but
it sold
was
like
fun.
A million.
That's what flopping is.
Yeah.
It sold
okay.
It was
fine.
Okay. It sold a million. That's not a flop, but it wasn't the big hit they wanted.
Okay.
The production values were all over the place. Like, there wasn't like a unified art style. Like, when you look at Smash, like all the characters look like they belong together. But like in PlayStation All Stars, it was like this caricature, like a cartoon character like Sly or Jack or something. Then you have realistic characters like Nathan Drake and the guy.
Right.
From
they
try
to make them all look like they look in their respective games.
Yeah, as
yeah.
opposed to like a unified art style for the game. And then like the menus were like somebody took like a day to make them. It's literally like a white background, like a green background, a red background.
It needed to cook a little more. It needed more PlayStation pizzazz, like, you know, like what Sony does. Well,
yeah,
needed some paprika.
Yeah.
And they didn't have all the characters people wanted. They didn't have Spyro. They didn't have Crash. They didn't have anybody from Final Fantasy.
I think Spyro or Crash?
I think that was the thing that killed it. Was that the
And they had Fat Princess.
They had Fat
it was like, come on.
And then they
that
had
bullshit.
They had the new Dante and Raiden. They didn't have Solid Snake. They had, what's it called? Big Daddy.
Yeah, there were just some weird choices.
They put me in that game?
Yeah.
Hey-o.
And then they did, I think the last DLC pissed me off.
Oh, it was so bad. It was the guy.
Isaac Clarke. Isaac Clarke from Dead Space and then Zeus from God of War.
Like, okay.
And then the next one is going to be like actual PlayStation characters. Abe from Abe's Odyssey and then Dart from Legend of Dragoon.
The stage that they were going to put out was going to be fucking awesome. It was going to be Gravity Rush mixed with Journey. And I saw like a couple screens and I'm like, dude, that looked so cool.
You said, so what's this about? They were going to? Is that like a DLC that
was
canceled?
Planned, and they canceled it because they just...
A DLC that was canceled or a sequel?
The DLC.
Oh, okay. All right.
Because there was like a bunch of linked like screenshots and like stuff. Like there was even a
bad.
Character model of Dart.
Yeah.
So...
Bastards.
Yeah. It really
would be cool to see Dart like in actual like... current graphics, yeah.
Yeah.
It needs to have the cheesy voiceover, though. Burn flame.
Yeah, exactly. It has to be exactly as bad as it was on PS1.
Double slash.
There you go.
Volcano! Everyone's so like, bad. No one who's ever, pardon me, everyone who hasn't played Legend of Energy Games is like, what the hell are you talking about? Are you high?
It was in the early days of voice acting, and it was just god awful.
Volcano!
early days of voice acting and translating.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. The combination just made it funny.
Yep.
What else, what are you guys looking forward to? The only thing I'm really looking forward to is Doom.
Okay.
Everything else, I'm just looking forward to seeing new announcements.
Warcraft 4, I heard they're announcing.
Yeah, Warcraft 4.
Can anybody confirm, deny?
Halo 5 Guardians, definitely.
Okay.
By the way, if anyone thought I was being serious about that, just no.
There is a PC conference, so you never know.
Blizzard is there.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
I think it's going to mostly be Overwatch, but you never know.
Right.
You never
They're
fucking
gonna
know.
They're going to show the trailer to Overwatch, and it's like, yeah, Overwatch looks awesome, and then suddenly...
If Warcraft 4 somehow gets announced, I might flip out and accidentally kill one of you guys. So just like, if it seems like...
Oh my god!
Oh. Smothering Taylor with the pillow. Warcraft!
Every one of our viewers is like...
Just guys watching getting murdered on live internet TV.
Kitchen knives. No, I'll freak out though. But yeah, sorry.
Yeah, that would be pretty awesome. We won't see it for about 5 years, but it'll be awesome.
Yeah, maybe 10, 15.
Yeah, I was being a little lenient on that.
Out of curiosity, when did Warcraft 3 come out? Just time wave.
Long time ago. Okay. Before World of Warcraft.
Really? Wow. You're right.
2001.
A couple of years before World of Warcraft.
2002.
That's
crazy. It's like almost 15 years old.
I think it was 2003.
Okay.
Or something like that. Right. But yeah,
and I still just played it 2 days ago. What's up?
What up?
It is a great game.
Condorius on US East.
12 years old. They're 12 years old, yeah. That's incredible.
I remember seeing the first trailer to Warcraft, World of Warcraft.
If you're trying to 1v1 or AT, yeah. Hit me up.
The world of World
Sorry,
of Warcraft.
Maybe
maybe there's like there's one person one on the guy. Planet.
Oh, yeah. Oh, hell yeah. Condorius on US East. Sick. Wait, why are you on US East?
There's more people.
Oh. Okay.
Yeah.
Good enough answer for me.
Go, Jake.
Go what?
Go.
He said Halo 5.
Yep. I'm out.
Fuck out of here.
Yeah, if you could hold your mic, you would drop it right there, right?
I would have. I did. It's just being held up by other things.
Just volleyball spike it.
So Halo 5.
Yeah, I don't know. Halo 5.
Did you know Phantom Dust was delayed or was... canceled?
Yeah.
Who is this guy?
I don't understand.
He's like in the middle of talking.
Why am I here?
By the way.
You just asked him a question.
No. Taylor, I'm not in the middle of talking. I'm in the middle of responding to him.
I know.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
please don't mix that up.
Dude, Connor, are you excited about that? It's Final Fantasy?
Yeah,
so
totally.
Like, so, Jake, what did you think about Mario?
Oh, thanks, dude. That was really nice.
Yeah. Oh, God, Nick.
I love you, man.
You're just the worst.
Nick, they both are talking over each other. Nick is saying, I love you, man. And Jake is saying, you're the worst. Got a good duality going on there.
It's a biology.
Yeah,
biology.
I didn't get it till like 60 seconds later when you said that. You're like, oh, bi means two. Fuck, I get it. God damn it.
But no, I don't. I mean... Halo 5 is the only one that's coming to mind. The problem is I can't think of...
Tomb Raider? Rise of the Tomb Raider?
I mean, sure.
Division?
Division, yeah. That's a big one.
Star Fox? Anything from...
Yes. Absolutely. I forgot. Yeah, Star Fox and Zelda definitely are big ones, but Star Fox more so. I think I'm actually more of a Star Fox fan than Zelda.
Oh, okay.
And especially
Star
since
Fox
it's...
Star Fox is more imminent. Yeah, it's going to come out.
Yeah,
before.
It's coming out this year, supposedly. So
that's going to be #BD.
Oh, it's going to be so much fun.
Yeah. Yeah.
Super Mario Universe.
Super Mario Universe?
Because it was like...
Oh, cool. Do you jump on guys' heads and collect coins, dude? Sick. I've never done that before.
They gotta make it. I mean, it's just made for
who
it.
Who gives a fuck about Mario? There's probably 100,000 people who want to kill me. No, but not that many people will ever see our podcast, but there's one guy somewhere that wishes I was dead right now for saying that, but who gives a fuck about Mario?
I can't believe this guy.
Yeah, it's Italian guy with a mustache and a plunger.
It's the actual voice actor. He's just sitting there like, oh, fuck you, Connor.
Yeah, he's trolling all the podcasts to see if anyone mentioned him.
That's all he does. When he's not voicing Mario, he just listens to podcasts.
But seriously, like...
all day.
Has no one jumped on a Koopa Troopa's head before? Who gives a flying fuck? Like, will Mario have an automatic weapon? Like, Give me something new.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe I don't know.
Mario and Mario the Hedgehog. Game.
Yeah.
Mario the Hedgehog.
Super Shadow.
Oh, God. Mario Man the Hedgehog.
Super Sonic Bros.
Yeah.
God. No, so, Sonic Boom 2.
Rated M Metroid game.
Sonic yeah. Doom. Oh, that would be amazing. Ooh, that would nice. Be... Rated M Metroid Prime-like
yeah.
game. Not other M, not original Metroid Prime. And Prime 2.
Make
and
it
Prime
like,
3.
So make it like Dead Space-y.
I'm going to drop a sad bomb on all you guys. Metroid doesn't sell very well. I don't know if you guys know that. Like, I was looking at some sales numbers. It never really lights the world on fire. So unless they went in like a drastic decision like Dead Space, like a first-person Dead Space or something like that, I don't even see why they'd bother.
But there's such fantastic games.
That is the problem. Like, yeah, I'm not like
Metroid Prime is so well done. That entire trilogy is beautiful.
So really, you're just casting shade on its ability to like make big waves.
Yeah, or make or be a financial.
That's really
financially viable. Yeah.
Let me drop another bomb on you. Neither does Resident Evil.
Yeah, it does.
Just six.
Taylor just waits a second and then goes, that's not true.
That is
you just
not
lied.
True. Nick is lie.
No. I'm pretty sure six is the best in the series, and it's a, like
but
five
everything
million.
Else did not sell that well. That's what I was going at. Is it?
I think it, like progressively it's been selling better over time, because five was the best selling, and then six, I think, was
well,
right up
well,
there.
Four kind of broke him out from like the just survival horror like
yeah,
pigeonhole.
It was like an action game at that point.
Well, we can go on about sleeper hits and flops all day. I mean, there's just so many of them.
Yep.
I
don't know why I just did that dance.
Probably because you're addicted to Splatoon, man. You're getting the shakes.
In my head, you said flop, and I was pretending to be like a fish flopping. Is what I was going for.
I thought you were pretending to be LeBron James. I hope LeBron. I hope you listen to shit. You Hollywood ass like, bitch.
That's what he does when he's not playing the game, playing basketball. No,
as soon as we post this episode, we like lose a like, and it's like LeBron
and LeBron.
Oh man, the LBJ apologists are frothing at the mouth. He flops. So does Steph Curry. Oh. Shit happens. It's basketball.
Yeah.
Back to video games.
Video games. I haven't said what I'm interested in, but I'm kind of the same thing with you for Uncharted. Like, I feel like when we're watching the conference and Uncharted comes on, I'm gonna like leave the room because I don't want to know anything about it because I know it's gonna be awesome. I want to see Battlefield. We haven't seen gameplay of Battlefield. This is like my most like I have no idea how this is gonna turn out kind of game.
Battlefront.
Sorry.
Yeah. Okay. I was like, Battlefield. Who cares
you,
about Battlefield?
Like, not Battlefield?
I don't know what Battlefield plays like. I've just never seen it before.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
no,
what do you do in that game?
I actually
do you shoot
forgot.
Guy, you walk. It's a walking experience.
Are there grenades? Are there vehicles?
I actually did forget
beings?
about Battlefront. That's another huge one that I'm looking forward to.
Yeah, because I mean, like on paper it sounds cool, but it's like, oh man, like Battlefield 4,
well,
like was not good.
Saying, everything they've been saying is like good stuff. I mean, it's hopeful. You know,
yeah.
The only I think negative thing is just no space combat. But even then, that's I mean I can live without.
I mean,
that.
There's still aerial dogfight battles.
Yeah, exactly.
But it's not in
so
space.
It's
like who cares?
Same yeah. shit. But you figure if they had aerial dogfight battles, there'd be an easy way to just be like,
make
man,
it all
here's
black.
Some space.
Yeah,
ones,
right. I don't know.
New skybox DLC.
Yeah. The one game I'm really hoping they show, and this might be a little too early to show it, is so the lady that was the writer for Uncharted, her name's Amy Hennig, she like left Naughty Dog and now she works at Visceral, the guys who did Dead Space, mm-hmm. and she's making a Star Wars game. And it's supposed to be like, in theory, like 1313, like a third-person character action game.
That'd
like,
be great. Like,
and so,
not much force or lightsabers.
Yeah, no, it'll be more like you're a trooper guy
blasters.
Or something. So I'm hoping they reveal that in some capacity. That's what I'm really looking
so
forward to.
So that game's going to be so uncivilized.
What?
What are you talking about?
That's an Obi-Wan Kenobi joke.
I don't think anybody got
oh, shoot,
it.
Man.
Like, we were
wow,
sort of
I totally
like,
went. I mean, but if it was really, if that's a quote. I mean, bad on us, I guess.
Yeah. Obi-Wan shit. Does not like blasters because it's uncivilized.
Huh.
Okay. Well, that was a deep cut, but I
why
see
why don't
you
drink some blue milk and take a break? Dang it, that was a ill-timed joke.
Connor, what? Why don't you just,
I want some blue
Connor,
milk is another
Connor,
niche Star
let's just,
Wars
let's
reference.
Handle the humor of the rest of the episode.
Yeah, yeah. I'll just stop right, talking.
Could you guys just give us factual analysis?
I mean, yeah. I gave you hey. Guys biology. And you give me this?
Okay. If
you guys I came with got, the Time was Jam master, well, you know the rest.
Yeah.
If anyone got my joke, leave a message.
All right.
Anyway, leave not a alone on this. Leave a message saying that he sucks.
Specifically. I'm really hoping they show Persona 5 and there's an announce, like a release date, because that game has been quiet for a while after they dropped that awesome trailer. Supposedly it's still coming out this year. I don't see how that's possible. But maybe they'll show up at Sony's conference and be like, boom, here's a sweet trailer coming out in like November or something like that. That'd be really cool. I'm trying to think of the rest of the, my like hopes are like pie in the sky, like Ni No Kuni 2 or something weird like that. Right. Or like a Last Guardian maybe showing up.
If we're making wish lists, I mean, yeah, Cubivore 2. Boom, right there on the list.
Crash Bandicoot.
Yeah.
Final Fantasy 7 2.
The remake, yeah.
7-2.
Except it's all chicks.
It's just Tifa walking around and Yuffie.
I'd buy it.
Yeah, and I'm like, I actually play that. and Cloud. Hey, yo, in drag.
Yeah, it's Tifa and Yuffie just carrying around Aerys' corpse.
Is it really Tifa or Tifa?
Dude, if no one's played FF, if someone hasn't played FF7, I'm so sorry.
I think it's actually Tifa and Yuffie, but it's like whatever. Like we, I think
if
we,
someone tries to correct me on that, I will fight you in the street.
Tifa.
All right, we'll have to settle this way. There's a camera right there. I can't do all the dirty legal shit I would do.
I think that's kind of it. I'm hoping maybe they'll bust out Gravity Rush 2 because they announced it a while ago and they haven't shown anything.
I hope they bust out a new model of the Vita.
Why?
I don't know. I think that
I need to upgrade mine because mine's dying.
No, don't say that. You just got Connor a Vita. Don't tell him that.
Yeah, and mine's cooler than yours right now, so I don't want that to change.
Yeah, just buy Connor.
It's the only thing I have that is remotely cooler than anything you own, so just let me have this. Holy shit, dude. My PS2 is about to stop working.
You're like, oh, you want to play Tower Fall on my PS4?
Fuck off.
Yeah, man, stop rubbing Towerfall in his face. Jeez.
That game is so advanced. Dude, I'm just kidding, dude. I'm totally just kidding.
Well, yeah, I brought Super Puzzle Bobble. It's like, that's cool. I'm playing Helldivers on my PS4.
So do we have anything else for today?
Yeah, more E3 stuff.
What more E3 stuff?
This E3 stuff.
I don't have any more
E3 stuff. Our E3 plans for all you guys.
Well, yeah. Well, we got our stream.
Yeah, we have our
That's
live
gonna
stream.
That's going to be a lot of fun,
which
actually.
Is going to be starting at 6:30 on Sunday, the 14th.
Yep.
Yep. And it's just going to be us. We just listen to us commentate on E3.
It's going to be sick. You should all hang out. It's going to be on the Last Honest Gamers Twitch. Nick, do you have the...
It's twitch.tv/dimlos2003.
We'll have the links.
D-Y-M-L-O-S. 2003.
Yes. We'll have links in the description.
And I think we'll have pre and post analysis or discussion or whatever you want to call it.
Absolutely.
And there may be gaps when the conferences are so spaced out that I think we were talking about playing games. If the gap's too far, we run out of things to talk about. So.
I think a Super Bust a Move tournament needs to be happening.
Oh, yeah.
For sure. But either way, if you're interested in E3 or even if you're not...
just hang out with us.
Yeah, just come hang out because we're going to be covering it. I mean, you can catch all the news from there just from us. You know, we'll be putting our wacky spin on it and having a good time and analyzing. So, yeah, come hang out. It'll be fun.
It will be fun. I like it. E3 is going to be fun.
It'll be fun. I like it.
And then he said it'll be fun again.
I want...
No, yes, it is our turn to make fun of Nick this week.
Nick,
it's all good.
Like thing, good.
Good, good thing. Well, we can't do Roll With It this week.
No,
it's been a long episode. Yeah. We're not going to have a next E3 episode. It's our live stream's going to be that. So we'll just probably put out a lot of videos of just our live stream discussions.
Yeah, because that's going to be like a month's worth of podcasts, if not more, because each of the conferences is like an hour each, if not more, and there's going to be like 6-7 of them. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
So. Yeah, if you want to, you know, stay tuned on updates, check it out on Twitter. We'll be posting updates and junk. So
yeah, definitely.
We'll give you those handles in a moment here.
Yeah. I'll give it to you now. You make sure to follow us on Facebook at The Honest Gamers, Twitter at The Honest Gamers. YouTube is The Last Honest Gamer. I'm going to change that to The Last Honest Gamers.
And, working on it.
Yeah, YouTube just takes forever to get that done. You can listen to us on iTunes and Stitcher. Thanks for watching. This is our first video podcast.
Yeah, the inaugural, you know, video podcast. So yeah. What's up,
people?
Hope
you liked it. Let us know your feedback if there's something we can fix or better. We'll have a better background next time.
Yeah, we're going to actually have a background. No fridge.
Won't look quite as janky.
Yeah, no jankiness.
Yeah, we're gonna style it out game style. So
it's not going to be janky either.
Until then, Last Honest Gamers.
Catch you later.